down amongst the trees just near our camp out of the wind. That's a big grass, isn't it?
Okay.
Yeah, it's got a permanent water supply. Beauty. Condongs. We'll make condong pancakes, shall we?
Well,
they've been eaten out, so plan B is croissants.
Strawberries and cream.
And strawberries and cream.
Bury them all over there.
They're beautiful little nuts.
Yeah, should bury them all over there. Let's see if they'll grow another one.
Yeah. Put them in the hole.
I was going to put them back under the tree.
There's another one from the opposite direction. There's even a smaller ant there with a little leaf. It's going in the opposite direction. There's a faster one. To turn his little shuttlecock around. There's a big ant going down the hole. A large red ant. He's raiding them. Or it's a queen. He's got it round the wrong way. Whole little world down there. We've planted a few kwandongs to grow next time we come back. And big ants are actually going somewhere else in this big hole here. It's got little ants in it. And big ants are heading off.
Rather than
going that way.
Going round by the smooth stuff.
One of the little seeds. Another little ants heading off that way. This must be a spider hole protected from the floods.
Spiderweb.
All wobbly.
That bloke is tapped.
The ant line
trap.
No, it just collapsed. He's waiting. Here's your ant. The ant house. It's got a few ant lines around it too. Here's one. He's captured a bigger ant. And he's heading off back over to the... Not far to go now. They straight across the scrub. Just nearby, a large excavation. It's tiny ants. An ant with a little bit of croissant. Come all the way from our tent. And it's gone down the hole. Still finding his way. He's got his own special hole. Maybe he's going straight through to another. This is the only wildlife. I wonder what his hole smells like. And there's a range of ants around living in close proximity. And this mound here, a little croissant carrying ant came from our tent over there. The ants are coming from these little bushes here. They must be climbing up and plucking them off. 11:15 and we're just heading off. Inspired the information. Where we are there now, in the Goldfields Woodland National Park. We're going down towards Hyden and Wave Rock. John. Wildflowers all the way along the road. We've got some grevilleas over here. These are the same.
Oh, see, that's the one with the little five little petals all on one side. I've seen it before.
There's some big bunches of these further down the road. Got pink ones. Holland trudged across here looking for water, scouting ahead. Day and a dray came. Just passed our first parenti in the middle of the road. So far the Holland Track's just been a nice laterite gravelled highway.
Well, this is the Holland Way, not Holland, Holland Track.
Holland Way.
John Holland Way. Here's the orange road, or the yellow road. We've got Revilleas up there. And the peak reveilliers up there. They're very tall. There's bees on them.
Horn or something flew off it just a moment ago. A motorbike went flying past us up in the opposite direction.
Avenue of these tall grevilleas.
They're all over there too, actually. It's not just a road.
All back through the sand. This is quite spectacular.
Most immediate takeaway shop in Boddington this afternoon. It's called the Golden Nugget.
It's not the ABC.
Yeah, country
out. Oh,
it is too. A lot of people drive off the track and all over the place in the scrub. And they come down here in the wet, drive through in the mud. Just to make a splash. Big four-wheel drive expeditions probably come through here. Leaving their tracks all through the scrub. Doing wheelies just in and out of the bushes on the lovely flat clay and leaving their tracks. Warning. You might miss it, 0.4 metres from a bearing of 10 degrees. This is the survey mark. That's the clear traverse through here. We've been listening to Radio National and the Country Hour about Boddington and all the super pit they're going to build there over the next few years. Huge gold mine. The super pit will be 7k long and there are thousands of new employees. That's the survey mark through there in the scrub.
Heading down the Thursday Rock. Yeah, I'd go around that. Yeah, it's got water in it. Bit of a mud hole there, so we'll take the detour. So, this is the Thursday Rock track, 2k's down here to lunch. The guys that cut the side track didn't put in as much effort as John Holland, suppose it's easier to get a four-wheel drive with power steering around than it was to get a dray.
Lovely salmon gum, really about the darkest we've seen. There's Mary up there swatting the marsh flies. As soon as you stop, you get covered with marsh flies. Thursday. One's being eaten by the other ones. Well, a few K away, and we've just come past the salt lake. The Yahoos, unfortunately, find it as well. Drive over the sand dunes and then do wheelies on the salt lake. That's why they ban four-wheel drives from national parks.
There's the mud. We're just going to go round the corner. Trailer missed the other tree on the left by 3 inches. Come out and negotiate the box. Oh, there's some more. Okay, we're out of the tree area now. Just cutting through the sandy area. Down the track a little, just down the track a little way, and we've got these lovely little flowers. They're very gorgeous, I think. Quite a big bush. And down underneath them, there's some other very pretty flowers. All around, and more of them. I don't think we've seen those first ones before. Darker purple ones that look the same, and the lighter whiter ones.
Just on the track.
So variation in colour. It looks as though they're just on the track. Obviously thrive on the disturbed soil. Heading back into Bravilia country again. Some nice pink ones back there too. This is just a kilometre from the last lot, and lots more out in the sand here. We've got this on about another 5 k's further on. We're into smoke bush country. The old man banks use, and we've just come through quite badly burned out area. Starting to get a few other little bits. Looks like a little dried out grassy, spinifexy thing almost, very prickly.
Bacon thing. It's miles in the distance.
Look at that. Those amazing leaves.
Just come up through that little gap onto the granite outcrop where you get green grass. And the guy here waiting for us. And spots there. Every damp grassy spot has been bogged in and driven over in deep ruts, and they would have had to winch themselves out of it. They've driven around looking for every grassy spot to get bogged in. Just an outrage. Past some other travellers who left Perth this morning at 5:30 a.m. Now it's 4:40. 20 to 5. And this is Krakow Rock. We probably won't go up and have a look. This is the rest of the Krakow Rock. And driving around and across it.
I was just about to pull over to him and he pulled off. He's got a trailer on, so he's pulled right off the road.
On the horseman. And a lizard just ran underneath it